Hello and welcome back to Coleford Plays Sly 2 Band of Thieves. Now last we had left off, we had just cleared a couple missions with Sly, Bentley, and Murray. Time for a Sly mission. Still getting ready for the Lumberjack Games. I don't actually know when those happen in terms of how many more missions we need to do for the Lumberjack Games to actually occur. I assume they gotta be soon. We have dodged, like, all these icicles just by chance.
In order to overcome Jean Bissad at the Lumberjack Games, we'll need to enlist the help of the giant Canadian eagles. Out on that iceberg. Steal one of the eggs, and then bring it safely back to the safe house. We'll use it to direct the eagle's protective instincts against Bissad.
Sure, sounds easy enough. Except for the part where I have to swim a half a mile through freezing water.
Why swim when you can paraglide? With the oil mains all destroyed, the pent-up combustible materials have just caught fire.
I see. The updraft created by the flame should give me some extra altitude.
Just make sure to stay out of the fire.
Get sounds good.
Close,
enjoy your coffee break.
We'll be eating barbecued raccoon for dinner.
That's a charming image, Bentley.
I see what I'm doing.
Watch out for those eagles, they don't look friendly.
What?
Thank you.
Agreed. It's a good morning for a cup of Joe. Ooh, I even have strawberry scones if I would like one. But I don't know if I would like one. Sounds pretty good. Sounds pretty darn good. Alright, let's not have the eagles break our paraglider this time. Let's safely land on the island.
Watch out for those eagles, they don't look friendly.
Oh God, I don't want to die here. Canadian Eagle Egg.
Excellent job. If you could get that Eagle Egg back to the safe house, we'll be all set for the Lumberjack Games.
Aha, so this is what I do. God, I knew it was gonna happen. I knew as soon as I even saw him, I knew I was gonna do it. I knew I was gonna try to jump in front of him. It did not work. My brashness failed me. My boldness. Just get back to the safe house.
Great work, Sly.
Do. 80% done. Nice.
The Lumberjack Games are upon us. Now, despite Murray's study of the log chopping guide, none of us are skilled enough to beat John Bassad at his own game. So, though it pains me to say it, we'll have to cheat. Murray, you'll participate in the power log chopping competition. Get us a good score, and then let Bassad up for his turn. While he's chopping, I'll sneak the eagle egg into his trousers, and the protective parents should disturb his axe swings. Sly, given your ascension skills, I've signed you up for the ice wall climb. We'll keep Bassad from beating your score by pulling him off the wall with some nearby grappling lines. And finally, I'll represent our team in the log rolling competition. With my knowledge of rotational mechanics, we're sure to get
a score. I remember the log rolling being particularly hard.
Sly will be in charge of greasing Bassad's logs, so he has no chance of beating it. If you guys are ready, I say we head out and show these meathead lumberjacks what we're made of.
Lumberjack games are on, mofos. Let's do it. Tony Bentley.
Okay, guys. Let's head down there and win those talons from Jean Bisson. Sly, try to keep a low profile when we get close. We don't want him to recognize you. Excuse me, sir. We humble lumberjacks would like to participate in your lumberjack games.
Got what it takes to win the clockwork talons, eh? Well, I'm sure enough gonna let you play, so long as you pay the entry fee.
Much obliged, partner. We'll just take our positions for the competition.
Enjoy the moment while you think you still got a chance. It's as close to winning as you'll ever get. This year's
All right.
first event will be a power chopping contest. Not like anyone's ever gonna beat my record, but let them try. Not bad, Hippo. But watch and learn as I destroy that log without even breaking a sweat.
10-10-10. We did pretty good.
Okay, Bentley, you're on. Plant the eagle egg on Bassan, and the angry eagle parent should swoop in and throw off his axe timing.
I love the music for the games. Oh, the egg broke! The birds, they be a swoopin'. Got him.
What? I think you better rethink them scores, boys. What you intended to give me was perfect tens, right? So your pink friend knows how to handle an axe. Let's see how you handle a vertical wall of ice. Showing up.
We had to keep hearing this music. The Great Lumberjack Game theme. This song's a bop. Electrocuted. What? There was still time on the clock. There was still a little sliver of orange. I saw it. Fuck.
Helping you any.
scared I'm gonna get worse.
Demonstrate the art of power climbing.
Use those grapples to hook onto Bizon. You will need to hook him with all three lines to pull him off the wall.
This one is going to take some practice.
Now that's how it's done.
I will say he's an excellent climber. Give him credit. I hooked him with two.
Now it's done.
Got him. Let's go. Easy peasy.
Seems you have pulled the wrong cards again. Did I ever tell any of you the story about the judge from last year's competition who mistakenly gave me a score other than 10? I see we're tied with only one event to go. Save my best event for the last, the spinning log competition.
It looks easy enough. I just need to stay out of the water.
Oh, God.
The legs of yours just can't move fast enough.
So focused. Focus has never been stronger.
Turtles aren't good at nothing.
Never mind, my focus was not good. Not good focus. I remember having so much difficulty with this on Vita. Right now it's like actually pretty doable. Ooh, alright.
One lucky turtle.
Hey, let's go.
Watch how a skilled log roller does it.
This
is crazy. John Bisson's got those judges so intimidated, there's no way he can lose.
Those guys need to go. Okay, I'm just making this up on the fly, but what if I were to lure the judges one by one into that cave? Once inside, you two will knock them out and take their clothes.
Genius! When all three judges have been restrained, we'll be able to don our disguises and take their place at the judges' table. Sly, you can use the alarm clock gadget to distract the judges and lure them into the cave.
It's a great plan, Sly, but you'll have to move fast. Once John Bisson finishes the log rolling event, the gig is up.
Oh, I can't be seen by a judge. I didn't think I was close enough. I mean, I guess I was, but... Oh my god. What? It didn't get him over? Alright, I'm just gonna have Jambi-san see me. Fail the mission. What did I do wrong to have him not go in the cave? Was he just not close enough? I guess not. He looked pretty fucking close to me. How close does he have to be? Let's see here. Let's see if we can't do this the right way. Okay. It's gotta be close enough. Duck Bentley, quack quack. Ducks, the quack squad, quack pack.
What? I thought I warned you judges about the consequences for incorrect scores. Wait a second. You aren't the judges I hired. It's the scrawny raccoon and his annoying friends. Well, if you want the challenge, then why don't you just take them?
Uh-oh.
my aching head. Those talons really pack a punch. Sly! Murray! Wake up!
Yeah, I'm awake, but not so loud. I have a splitting headache.
Where are we? What's going on?
This looks like the sawmill control room. Bissad must have thrown us in here for interrogation later. I, for one, would like to escape before he returns.
It looks like we're pretty well sealed in here. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless you can fit through that hole.
I think I could squeeze through there. I'll drop down and try to free you guys from the outside. If there's any trouble, I'll call with this walkie-talkie. You might be able to help me with these sawmill controls.
While you guys do that, I'll try prying open that steel door. Given enough time, I might be able to make some progress.
Sounds like a plan. Good luck, Bentley. And remember to shout if I can help you from up here.
Oh boy.
Bentley, you okay? I can't see you from in here, but I heard the fall.
I'll be fine. Just give me a moment to catch my breath.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, Candy Bridges. I should have figured a puny turtle like you'd find a rat hole to squirm through.
Well, I just dropped my glasses, had to come pick them up.
I ain't like you, boy. I ain't stupid. When y'all were unconscious, me and my boys paid a visit to your hideout and found all them clockwork parts.
Not our clockwork parts, no! What the heck?
King's ransom for the whole lot. I even threw in the talons.
You sold all the clockwork parts? Arpeggio has them all?
I wouldn't expect one of your kind to understand the finer points of commerce. You turtles are too stupid to know a woodcutter from a woodchuck.
That's it. Time I showed you just how stupid we turtles really are. Fine, on my command.
I hear you.
I love Bentley in this game. I'm gonna preach it from the heavens. Okay, this is Bentley's best game.
Get ready for a smushing.
Call out which lever I should pull. Okay.
I hit myself with blades. Oops. Alright, that was a gimme.
Was there ever any doubt of the victor?
Alright, John Bisson, how about we chill here?
Lever I should pull.
Square for flames, triangle for...
Wait.
Come on in here, boys. Let's get this varmint.
Scary.
Dynamite turtle.
Fire.
Okay.
Log. Dynamite. Sizzle and gizzle.
Come on, boys. Let's get to killing.
We got this. We got this.
Thank you.
John Bisson taken out.
You've been done in by some four-eyed turtle? Times have changed.
Once again, brains triumph over brawn.
Good job, little buddy. That was some fast thinking.
Don't forget about me.
You did a great job opening that door, Murray.
Thanks.
attention, John Bisson. Our PGO's carrier blimp will arrive to pick up the Northern Light battery in exactly 1 minute.
Okay, enough patting ourselves on the back. If we're going to get the clockwork parts back, we need to get onto that blimp.
Yes, the other
silo
way.
Battery isn't far. If we run, we can make it.
Enough talk, let's move!
Shake a leg! That blimp's on its way!
There's the team. Doom, 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 doom. Nice.
As we shut ourselves into the Northern Light battery, it became black. For a few long minutes, we just sat there in darkness. No one dared to talk for fear that John Bisson's men might discover where we were hiding. Time seemed to have stopped. And then, we felt it. We were being lifted up to Arpeggio's blimp. It was all so strange. The focus of all our schemes had been stolen from us. Our clockwork parts were gone. Looking around the inside of the battery, I knew we all felt it. Failure. I was twitchy and ready for action. Any action. Bentley tried to make some sense of the situation by drawing up meaningless plans. But Murray took it the worst. He just sat there sobbing while the team van floated away over the horizon. That van was his life. I knew I'd have to find a way to make it up to him.
Aw, poor Murray. Makes me sad. Alright, episode 8, Arpeggio's Blimp. We will tackle it next time on Coleford Plays, but until then, I hope you do well. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe right down below in the comment section. It truly does mean a lot to us when you decide to do so. If you don't, you know, I understand. It's okay. You don't have to. Other than that, we wish you well. We hope that you and yours are doing A-okay. Please be kind to others. Please be kind to yourself. And we'll see you next time for more Coleford Plays. Take care. Have a good one. Bye-bye.